Welcome students to the quick solution of All India Cast test series Medical 2020 for TYM. This is test number 7, code C and D for chemistry, conducted on 31st of March 2021. So let's start with the first question of chemistry students, which is question number 46. Let's read it. When 2 moles of Na2CO3, that is sodium carbonate, reacts with 6 moles of HCl, the volume of CO2 gas liberated at STP will be. So student, first of all, for this question, we have to write the balanced reaction that occurs between sodium carbonate and HCl. So I'm writing it. Na2CO3, this reacts with 2 moles of HCl to give 2 moles of NaCl and CO2 and H2O. We are given with 2 moles of Na2CO3. And 6 moles of HCl. So student, here first of all we have to identify the limiting reagent. Here we can clearly see that 2 moles of HCl reacts with 1 mole of Na2CO3, that is sodium carbonate. So 6 moles of HCl will react with 3 moles of Na2CO3, but we are given with 2 moles. That means Na2CO3 is the limiting reagent. Now we know that the amount of product formed depends upon the limiting reagent. Here we can clearly see that 1 mole of Na2CO3 reacts to give 1 mole of CO2. That means 2 moles of Na2CO3 will give 2 moles of CO2. So we can calculate the volume of CO2 liberated. So volume of CO2 liberated at STP will be number of moles of CO2 multiplied by 22.4 liter. Since we know that volume of 1 mole of a gas at STP is 22.4 liter. So number of moles of CO2 will be 2 multiplied by 22.4 liter, which is equals to 44.8 liter. That means the correct answer is option number 2. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 47. Let's read it. How much H2O should be added in 100 ml 0.3 molar aqueous NaCl solution so that the resultant molarity of solution becomes 0.1 molar? Student, for such question, we know the formula used is M1V1 is equals to M2V2. Here, initial molarity given is 0.3 and the initial volume is 100. And the final molarity is 0.1. We have to calculate the final volume first. So, volume, that is V2, is equals to 0.3 into 100 upon 0.1, which is equals to 300 ml. Now student, we can calculate the amount of or the volume of water added is equals to 300 ml minus initial volume, which was 100 ml, which is equals to 200 ml. That means the correct answer is option number 2. Moving to the next question, which is question number 48. Let's read it. Atomic number of the element having symbol UNH is? First of all, student, we need to know that UNH represents un-nil hexium. Here, un represents 1, nil represents 0, and hex represents 6. That means atomic number of the element having symbol UNH is 106. That means the correct answer is option number 1. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 49. Let's read it. Correct order of first ionization enthalpy is? Student, here we are given with 3 elements of second period and we have to identify the correct order of ionization enthalpy. Students, in general, on moving left to right in the modern periodic table, the value of ionization enthalpy increases because the effective nuclear charge increases. But there are some exceptions. I'm writing the value of ionization enthalpy of some of the elements of second period. So, order of ionization enthalpy, I'm writing correct order of ionization enthalpy is, highest is for fluorine, then we have nitrogen, then we have oxygen, followed by carbon, further followed by beryllium, then we have boron, then we have lithium. Here if we compare beryllium and boron, though boron is on the right side of beryllium, so it is expected that the ionization enthalpy of boron must be higher. But in case of beryllium, there exists fully filled 2s subshell. The last electron is removed from this fully filled 2s subshell, obviously, which is difficult because we know that fully filled subshells are highly stable. Therefore, the ionization enthalpy in case of beryllium will be more than that in case of boron. Same with oxygen and nitrogen. Though oxygen lies on the right side of nitrogen in the modern periodic table, therefore it is expected that the ionization enthalpy of oxygen should be more than that of nitrogen. But in case of nitrogen, there exists exactly half filled p subshell. The electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2 2s2 2p3. So here the p is exactly half filled, and we know that the exactly half filled subshells are highly stable. That means the amount of energy required by nitrogen to remove one of its electron will be extremely high because of its stability. As a result, the ionization enthalpy of nitrogen becomes more than that of oxygen. So, among the given options, the correct order is represented in the third option. Moving to the next question, which is question number 50. Let's read it. Which of the following sets of quantum numbers it's not possible? So let's start. N is equals to 5 L 2 M minus 1 S plus half. This is possible. N 5 2 2 S plus half possible. 5 1 2 minus half. This is not possible since here the value of M is 2. That of L is 1. We need to know that for L is equals to 1, the value of M varies from minus 1 to plus 1. That is minus 1, 0 and plus 1. That means the set of quantum numbers represented in the third option is not possible. So the correct answer is this. Here, let's check out option number 4 also. So 5, 1, minus 1, minus half. This is also possible. That means the correct answer for this question is option number 3.